Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired Word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today, and we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
when God, as man, descended unto us to erase the stain of sin and put an end to wrath. The entire world thrills with hope on this night that gives it a savior. My people, kneel down and await your deliverance. For Christ has come, the Redeemer is here. May the ardent light of our faith guide us all to the cradle of the infant. As in ancient times a brilliant star guided kings from the east, the King of Kings was born in a humble manger. He has broken every bond. The earth is free and heaven is open. He sees a brother where there was only a slave. His love unites those that iron had chained. Who will tell him of our gratitude? For all of us, he is born. For all of us, he suffers and dies. And for all of us, he lives again. My people, stand up. Sing of your deliverance. Shout for joy and sing praise to the Redeemer. This holy night, this night divine, come and praise his name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim.
Welcome to the United Methodist Church of Wilton. I'm Pastor Steve, and on behalf of the whole congregation here, I welcome you to our Christmas Eve candlelight service. Obviously, this is not the way we had planned Christmas Eve, to do it virtually by long distance, by camera, by internet. But a few hints tonight as we get started. Dim the lights in your room. In fact, I would say if you can, shut the lights completely off so it's just you and whatever device you're using. If you want to get yourself a candle to light when we get to Silent Night to help you connect and spread the light of Christ out into this world, that would be fabulous. But tonight we're going to be singing, we're going to be praying, we're going to be sharing the good news of Jesus Christ in a way that we would traditionally do, but through a unique new avenue. So as we prepare our minds, our hearts, and our souls to bring the light of Christ into our virtual sanctuary, I pray that all of you can find a bit of joy tonight to celebrate the light of Christ.
A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of its roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, and the Spirit of counsel and might.
The time is upon us. A historic moment has arrived for all humanity. Tonight fulfills the word of the prophets of the promised coming of the Messiah. Tonight is the night of our salvation. Glory to God in the highest.
We begin by lighting the candles of hope, faith, joy, and peace. Tonight, we light the Christ candle as a sign of God's love for us. No longer waiting on the threshold, instead, we welcome our special guest, the Savior of the world. Join in the Christmas Eve call to worship. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord. Bless his name.
Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all people.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised.
The time is upon us, so let the heavens be glad, let the earth rejoice.
We are no longer waiting on the threshold. Tonight, we welcome our special guest, the Savior of the world.
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old. From angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold, he saw
Christmas Eve. If you have a joy or concern that you would like to share with your brothers and sisters in Christ, I would encourage you to put it in the chat section or the comment sections. There will be in the comment sections and chat section, I will list the prayer concerns that I have as of this moment. But we need to lift each other up in prayer. For as exciting as Christmas Eve is, as holy as Christmas Eve is, there are those who are in the hospital. There are those that are hurting, those that are alone, those that are mourning. So let us continue to remember that in the midst of our joy, in the midst of our celebration, to remember those who Christ is holding tonight to get them through the night. So let us come together with our unison prayer.
Let us pray.
God of every nation and people, from the beginning of creation, you have loved us. When our need for a Savior was great, you sent your Son. He brings joy, peace, mercy, and love to our lives. Bless all who look upon the manger,
May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus. The time is upon us to raise up our thoughts to him who is God with us and Savior of all. Amen.
As we come to our pastoral prayer, there will be a time of silence led into the Lord's Prayer. So let us pray. Lord, I ask that you pour out your Holy Spirit on us on this holy night, this night in which we remember the shepherds arriving, the good news being proclaimed. Lord, we ask that you continue to wash over us, fill us with your Holy Spirit wherever we're at. Lord, help us in our discomfort in doing worship this differently. Be with us as we try to grasp hold of that meaning of candlelight and worship. Lord, be with the families that are separated because of these times. Be with those who are alone for the first time. Lord, be with those who are working in our hospitals and our care centers, dealing with those that are sick and broken. Lord, we ask that you continue to watch over all those who are dealing with issues of inadequate housing and clothing, having a tough time paying their utility bills or putting food on the table. Lord, this is a stark reminder for those of us that have so much compared to those who have so little. So Lord, help us to be generous with one another, to love each other. Lord, we ask that you be with those who are working tonight as law enforcement, fire departments, EMTs and ambulance drivers, nurses and doctors, those on the front lines dealing not only with issues of crime and violence and hate, but dealing with viruses and COVID and illnesses of the mind, body, heart, and soul. So Lord, tonight, as we light our candles, as we sing our glorious songs, we ask that you move us and prepare us to be agents of change in this next year, to take the good news of your birth and spread it to all those who can hear. Lord, help us to live in ways that bring about glory and honor to you. Lord, if the shepherds could do it, in their status and in their place, we know that we can do it. Those that heard the good news and lives were changed, Lord, we thank you and praise you and help and ask that you continue to use us. But in order for that to happen, Lord, we need to come to you in a time of silence so that you can move our hearts, our minds, our souls, so that you can work within us to prepare us, to show us which way to go, how to get there, and what to say when we get there. So Lord, come, be with us now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for being with us, for washing over us, for cleaning us up and forgiving us, for your grace to flow over us so that we can share your good news to all around us. So Lord, we come to you now praising you with that prayer that you taught your disciples.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
The good news. Those who have prayed that prayer, those who have opened up their hearts, wherever you're at, God is with you, Emmanuel, helping you to find the Holy Spirit to find you, and the combination of the two to go out and to change your part of the world. So let us thank God for all that God is doing, all that God has yet to do, so that we may proclaim those miracles and give credit to our Most High. Hey, boys and girls, welcome to Children's Time. This is Christmas Eve, and hopefully you're all good. You've all been ready. You're all prepared. You've been doing the things I've advised you to do to help your parents out this Christmas. But today we're going to look a little bit more at the Peanuts gang and their Christmas special. I've talked to you about the fact that really, in some ways, even though the story is about Charlie Brown, Linus, as I told you last week, is kind of their prophet. He tells them the truth. And when Charlie Brown gets really discouraged, and he doesn't understand what Christmas is all about, Linus tells him. So I have something I want to share with you, something some of you may know, but a lot of you don't, is Ann and I have a lot of Christmas ornaments, and we have a full tree of nothing but Charlie Brown ornaments. Lots of Snoopy's, Charlie Brown, Linus, Lucy, Sally, all the whole gang is on one of our Christmas trees, as well as a large display area. So today I want to share with you one of our ornaments. It's a very special ornament, and it has Linus on it. And so I'm going to, and it tells a story. So I'm going to share that with you now.
And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were sore afraid, and the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God, and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
Pretty cool, huh? Hard to believe that they can make an ornament that says that. But that's the truth. Jesus was born for us long ago, in a far-off land called Bethlehem, in Palestine, to loving parents in a humble manger, feed trough. So remember that tomorrow, when you're celebrating and you're with your family, you're opening your presents, that the greatest gift that we've ever gotten was baby Jesus. So let us pray. Lord, I thank you for each and every one of these little ones, that this Christmas may be special to them, that they remember Jesus as they open up his birthday gifts to them, the gifts from their parents and grandparents, aunts, uncles, brothers and sisters, that they may remember in the joy of that moment, the joy that Jesus is a part of their life. So Lord, I thank you for them, and I thank you for their joy. And I look forward to the time when I can see that joy personally on their face. So Lord, I thank you for them, for what you have planned for them and for their future. Amen. Now this Sunday, there will be another children's message and another virtual Sunday school in the afternoon. So keep looking. Now, I promise you a surprise. And so if you're here tonight, you'll find out what it is. If you partake on the Sunday afternoon coloring sessions and making icicles with me to hang in your window or on your Christmas tree, I am going to be giving each and every one of you that have turned in a photo to me so that I can put it on our YouTube or Facebook photo album. Each of you will be getting a $5 gift certificate to the Candy Kitchen so that you can go get some snacks. Get one big snack, get five little snacks, whatever it is that you can do. And do it safely with your parents. But I will be getting those together and sending those out right after Christmas so that you can have them in January to celebrate Christmas through the church. God bless. We come to that time of our worship service to take up our gifts and our tithes, a time where we can give back to God a portion of what God has gifted us. I realize that during this time of pandemic and this time of layoffs and furloughs that not everybody has the capability to give, and that's okay. Take care of yourself, take care of your family. There are plenty of people taking care of the church during this time for us to get through. For those of you that would like to contribute to the mission and ministry of our church, there are several ways that you can do that. You can write a check, mail it to the church at Post Office Box 57, Wilton, Iowa, 52778, or you can go to our website, www.umcofwilton.org, click on the button for online giving. We have partnered with Vanco to make it safe and secure for you to give online. At this time, I want to thank you for all the support that you have given our church. If any of you are in need of assistance, please give me a call. I have funds for helping out members of the church. As these gifts come from all of us, let us join our voices together to dedicate these gifts to God's mission and ministry. Let us pray.
O Savior of the world, we come to dedicate all we have and are to your glory. In this moment of worship, we offer you our love. In this moment of prayer, we offer you our resources. In this moment of giving, we offer you ourselves. Use us, all that we have and all that we are, to touch the world with the Christmas message. God is love. God is with us. God will never leave us. Amen.
Hello, church family. Merry Christmas. I'm going to sing Hallelujah Christmas version. Hope you enjoy. I've heard about this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just want to sing this song to you. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child, they searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Star shone bright up in the east, to Bethlehem the wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place at which you were, their frankincense and gold and myrrh they gave to you and cried out hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 I know you came to rescue me. This baby boy would grow to be a man and one day die for me and you. My sins would drive the nails in you. That rugged cross was my cross too. Still every breath you drew was hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
Tonight's message, our section here, will be filled with scripture, will be filled with song, will be filled with some stuff that I want to share with you. We'll be looking, as we have in the past, the Old Testament lessons of Isaiah, as well as the Gospel of Luke, and what they can mean for us on this holy night to prepare us, to equip us, and to send us like shepherds. For now is the time.
Our Old Testament reading for Christmas Eve from the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Mighty God.
In those days, Caesar Augustus declared that everyone throughout the empire should be enrolled in the tax lists. This first enrollment occurred when Quirinius governed Syria. Everyone went to their own cities to be enrolled. Since Joseph belonged to David's house and family line, he went up from the city of Nazareth in Galilee to David's city, called Bethlehem in Judea. He went to be enrolled together with Mary, who was promised to him in marriage, and who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn child, a son, wrapped him snugly, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the guest room.
Oh,
Nearby, shepherds were living in the fields, guarding their sheep at night. The Lord's angel stood before them. The Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Look, I bring good news to you, wonderful, joyous news for all people. Your Savior is born today in David's city. He is Christ the Lord. This is a sign for you. You will find a newborn baby wrapped snugly and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great assembly of the heavenly forces was with the angel, praising God. They said, "Glory to God in heaven and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go right now to Bethlehem and see what's happened. Let's confirm what the Lord has revealed to us." They went quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw this, they reported what they had been told about this child. Everyone who heard it was amazed at what the shepherds told them.
Have heard on high, sweetly singing all the
committed these things to memory and considered them carefully. The shepherds returned home, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. Everything happened just as they had been told.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds God and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold and myrrh, compassion king to
Christ, the story of angels and shepherds, singing of the coming epiphany of wise men, that special time in history when the whole world changed. This past 4 weeks of Advent, we've been looking at what it meant to be prepared, to get ourselves a crew ready, a cleanup crew. And then actually, the next week, we looked at what it meant to be getting cleaned up, that preparation time of getting the house physically ready. The third week, we looked at decking the halls, the upright, the lights, the decorations of what it means to have somebody come into our home. And then this last Sunday, we looked at standing on the threshold, standing in a place waiting for the guests to arrive, but yet it was more than that, for as we stood on a threshold, we knew that that threshold meant change. And tonight, it is the time. Some of you may know that when I sign my artwork, my mark on the bottom of a print or a drawing or a painting looks like just an ST. That came from poor penmanship as a child and then evolved into an artist's mark for the name Steve. The EVE just became a line followed after the T. But a cute story, Ann's mom, when I signed a letter to her when Ann and I were first engaged, she thought I had put Saint down, ST period, and thought that was very unusual. So we explained to her that no, that was just the way that I made my mark wrote my name. And then as I went to art school, as I developed what I wanted to be my mark, my signature for artwork that could be unique to me, it became just that stylized ST. And then while I was in seminary, as I did more research, for one, as a graffiti artist, somebody who is putting their mark out there, I wanted it to even mean more. So ST, when I looked it up, actually stands in Latin as the abbreviation for sign temporis. It's very similar to the AM and PM markings for time, but sign temporis means, depending on exactly how you translate, it means without time or now is the time. Some of you may have heard of that urban legend of the fact that if you show up for class and your teacher or professor doesn't show up in 10 or 15 minutes, you're allowed to leave. Well, that is a bit of an urban legend, but it has some reality. For when they used to ring the bells, when that was the only way you could tell what time it was, classes would be marked, say, at 10 o'clock. ST, which means that the class would actually start at 10:15. And thus, if you weren't there by 10:15, you were late. Or vice versa, if the professor didn't show up by 10:15, 15 minutes after the marked time, when you got to the sign tempor, or when you were without time, or that now is the time, that meant there was no class that day, or you were so late you didn't get in. So once I discovered that, that became also part of my mark. So it's an ST, and then I write in Latin underneath it, sign temporis. And I take the definition as now is the time. Christ is calling us, for now is the time. Now is the time, like those shepherds. When they heard that word, now was their time. They got up and they left and they went to Bethlehem. They followed the instructions of the angels and found that babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a feed trough. Now is the time. Or if you take the other translation of it as without time, which means there's no more time left to go do something else. The shepherds were without time too. They had to get moving. We have to get moving. So this Christmas, as we celebrate and as we worship, we need to remember that Christ has put us here. God's plan has us, you, me, this church, specifically in this place, at this time, to do something for the kingdom of God. Now is the time. We don't have the time to wait until spring. We don't have the time to wait until summer, even though that would feel very handy at the moment, knowing that we are still in modes of separation and isolation, probably for another 3 to 6 months in one form or another. I mean, the good news is that we will slowly start to get back to some kind of new normal. But God doesn't want us to wait. Waiting never makes anything better. I know that often when we were children, we were told, you know, waiting for your birthday is good for you. Waiting for Christmas is good. But there are some things waiting isn't good for. Waiting for a couple of weeks to drink the milk in the refrigerator probably will end up with curds in your mouth. Waiting too long to enjoy something, it often spoils. Dries up. No longer has the taste and the flavor. Scripture that we had earlier in this season, Christ called us to be the salt and the light. If we wait too long, salt loses its saltiness. The moisture in the air starts to deteriorate until it doesn't mean anything. The light. If I wait too long, if I preach too long, these candles will go out. The oil will run out, the wick will dry up, and I won't have the light. I won't be the light. Christ is calling us now, at this time, like he called the shepherds, like he called Mary and Joseph, like he called the three wise men from the east. Like he called the disciples. And he's been calling people every day since then. Can you imagine if Jesus had gone up to one of the disciples on the boat and said, come follow me. And he's like, no, we're busy. We'll come back next season. We'll be better. And who knows, maybe some did. I know for myself personally, when I was called by God in high school, I decided to wait. I didn't think it was ready. And now maybe in the long run, God can do different things and better things. But there's part of me that regrets not taking on that challenge. When I first heard the call, when my heart was first strangely warmed, where would we be as Methodists that if on that night in May, when John Wesley went to a reading of Romans, and his heart was strangely warmed, if he said, oh, that felt really good, I think maybe next year I'll do something about that. I often worry about our youth and young adults who take gap years after high school because they want to wait and experience the world. Sometimes that is the right decision, but sometimes I worry that those gap years turn into gap years. And they never continue on in the progress they were at. Slowing down, taking our time, often is not a good result. That doesn't mean we don't smell the roses along the way, that we don't appreciate life as it comes at us. But God wants us to always be prepared to tell that story. The scripture tonight tells us that the shepherds, as they left that place, they told everyone. And everyone was amazed at what they heard. The shepherds didn't just pick out those that they thought would be receptive. They didn't pick out the ones that were friendly and close to them. It says that they told everybody. So this Christmas, as you gather in however way you're gathering, by Zoom or by distance or with masks, share the good news of Jesus Christ. There may be somebody in your family that has not heard that. And share your good news of Jesus Christ. How you met Jesus. How Jesus changed your life. And the glory that you have experienced on a day-by-day basis because Jesus was part of your life. For now is the time. God is wanting us. God is wanting me and you, this church, this community, to make a difference. So my challenge for you, as we leave this place, as we light our candles, as we sing with joy, as our hearts swell, that between now and Easter, we have at least three opportunities to share the good news of Jesus Christ with somebody different. Let us pray. Lord, tonight is the time. We ask that you move your Holy Spirit through us, through our devices, wrap your arms around us, help us to feel your experience of grace and love so that we can share that with those around us. That this does not become merely a holiday of family celebration and gifts, but becomes a remembrance of your appearance. Emmanuel, you with us. Lord, help us to remember that, to use that as what we say when we give gifts. I give you this gift because God loves you. Lord, help us to be those kind of people so that your love shines through us in all that we do and all that we say. Amen.
My name is Melanie Berry, and I will be singing the song One King for my grandma, Glenna Vanetta.
Come to this part of our service where we traditionally would light the candles from the Christ candle and spread it out across our sanctuary. If you have a candle, get it ready to light it, whatever time feels appropriate. We have a video that you can sing along to Silent Night. Members of the congregation have provided me photos of them or small videos, and it will be a display that hopefully gets at least an inkling closer to what we would have had here tonight. So at this time, let us take the light of Christ from here and not only spread it across our screen, but spread it around the world.
It truly is a silent night. As we enter into this day of Christmas, somewhere in the world it is already Christmas. The sun is already coming up. But tonight, as we enter this cold, dark night, let us remember why Jesus came. For the least, the lost, for those of us that have sinned, for those that are needing of grace. So we ask, Lord, that you be with those who are hurting and alone, those that are dealing with addiction and abuse, those that are neglected, feeling unloved. Lord, help us to be your hands of joy and peace on this Christmas day. So, Lord, be with us as we ring in the Christmas day, hearing the bells.
The sound of joy, joy, the sound.
I just love Joy to the World. Turn on the lights. We all bustle out with the love of Christ in our hearts. So I ask that you may now go with the peace of Christ, the love of Christ. Take the joy of Christ now, because now is the time for you to share that wherever you're going, with whoever you're with. And may God continue to shine His light on your path so that you can continue to be the light and salt of this world. Amen.
The stain of sin and put an end to wrath. The entire world thrills with hope on this night that gives it a savior. My people, kneel down and await your deliverance, for Christ has come. The Redeemer is here. May the ardent light of our faith guide us all to the cradle of the infant. As in ancient times a brilliant star guided kings from the east, the King of Kings was born in a humble manger. He has broken every bond. The earth is free and heaven is open. He sees a brother where there was only a slave. His love unites those that iron had chained. Who will tell him of our gratitude? For all of us, he is born. For all of us, he suffers and dies. And for all of us, he lives again. My people, stand up. Sing of your deliverance, shout for joy, and sing praise to the Redeemer. This holy night, this night divine, come and praise His name forever. His power and glory evermore proclaim.